okay. So that is what we are going to do in this particular module. Let's just look at the example of the infinite series expansion of e to the power x. So as we had said before, e to the power x can be written as 1 plus x square by 2 factorial plus x cube by 3 factorial and so on. Okay, so this is an infinite series. The greater the number of terms that you use, more accurate your results are going to be. Okay, so let's look at the problem of e to the power 1. Now e to the power 1, it's 2.718282. okay, so we are stopping at essentially this particular point, and what this signifies is the number of significant digits. I will come to that later. Number of significant digits. Okay, now this is the actual value of e to the power 1. We will call this as star to represent that it is a true value. Okay, now we will try to get the approximate values of e to the power 1 by including additional terms in this infinite series. Okay, so if we use only the first two terms of this infinite series, we will get e to the power 1 approximate, the subscript a stands for approximate, is 1 plus 1, that is going to be equal to 2. So if you see the difference between the true value of e to the power 1 and the approximate value of e to the power 1 is going to be significant when you are just going to include only the first term over here. Okay, this difference between the two is what is known as error. Okay, so error is going to be defined as the difference between the true value minus e to the power 1 approximate value. Okay, now we don't want to bias ourselves saying that the positive error is acceptable or negative error is acceptable and so on. Error in either direction is not acceptable. What we want to do is we want to really reach the value 2.718282 as closely as possible. So the error is actually going to be defined as the absolute value of the difference between the two. Okay, this is known as the absolute error, and we will represent it as EA, the absolute error. Okay, so now the absolute error is not the only criterion that we are interested in. What is sometimes more useful is to find out how far the two numbers deviate compared to what the true value of e to the power 1 is. And in that particular case, the error, which is known as the relative error, which we will represent using the term epsilon, that we will define as the absolute value of the true value minus the approximate value divided by the true value. Okay, so this is the relative error that we are interested in tracking. Now let us involve, instead of just the first two terms, we will involve the first three terms over here, and in that particular case e to the power 1, or I should actually be writing it approximately equal to, is 1 plus 1 plus 1 by 2, which is equal to 2.5. So now what you see is the error has decreased when you are increasing the number of terms in this expansion, the infinite series expansion of e to the power x. Okay, so the error over here is going to be 2.718 minus 2.5, that is 0.218282. okay, that's what the error is going to be when we include three terms. Now we can include additional term. When we include the fourth term, what we will find is the error is going to be 1 by 2 plus 1 by 6. It's going to be 2.5 plus 0.18. So that will be 2.617778. Okay. So now this value is getting closer to the value 2.71828. So what we see over here is as we include additional terms in this infinite series expansion, okay, we are getting closer and closer to the true value of e to the power 1. Okay. So that leads me to the first definition that is of importance to us, and that definition is truncation error. Okay. Truncation error comes up because we are not going to use infinite number of terms in this series expansion, but at some point of time we will say that we are not going to use any additional term, and this current approximate value is sufficient for our purpose. So the truncation error comes about because we are truncating this infinite series at certain point. So what happens is when we truncate this series at this particular location, the difference between the approximate value of e to the power 1 and the true value of e to the power 1 is arising because we are truncating at the second term. In the second case, this truncation error is dropping. The reason why this truncation error is dropping down is because we have used an additional term in this error in this approximate value of e to the power 1. Okay. So the idea about truncation error is because it arises because we are truncating the infinite series. Okay. So that is where the truncation error arises. Now the second type of error, which is of vital importance to us, is what is known as the round off error. Okay. So for example, if you are using a calculator like I am using, okay, the maximum number of digits in this particular calculator are going to be 10 digits. Okay. So you can only represent numbers up to 10 significant digits using a calculator of the kind that I am using. So any error that comes up because you are chopping off the remaining part of the number is what we call as the round off error. For example, e to the power x is actually not 2.718282. if you include additional terms, it might end up being 2.718818, and then additional terms beyond that particular value. So when we are stopping at this particular point, okay, what we are essentially doing is we are neglecting all the data beyond this particular value. Okay. So the round off error now comes up because we are chopping in our mathematical representation, we are chopping off the way we are representing a complete number.